Hello? Hello? You're cutting out. Are you able to send someone to look? Jesus Christ. I know it's not your fault. But I've been on hold for an hour and a half. Can you hear me now? Of course. I've restarted 15 times. But why not? I'll try again. Hello? Yes, I will hold. I swear to God, I'm gonna scream. Hello? Who is this? Where's who I talked to before? What disrespect? Not at all. Could you let me speak? I'm actually waiting for another call right now. Yes, I understand. I'm sorry. Sure. I'll wait. Hello? Just a sec. Hi. Are you there? I can't see you. Can you see me? You know how bad it is in here? The only place in this whole building I can get any service is the stage. Yeah. Yes. No. I'll turn video off then too. I just got back in from downtown. You didn't call while I was on the train. Oh, no, no. I went for a drink with Catherine. I forgot we have her keys. Are you at home? Could you check the drawer in the table by the door? I can't think where I left them. Yeah, sure. That'd be nice. Last night, I got in and made up the cot in the office. But after an hour of lying awake, I took one of my pills. No, just one. About 11, I thought I was getting a migraine, but this morning I feel better. Catherine came by, we went for a walk by the water. I got some groceries and bought a lamp for by the bed. Then, what? I'm fine, thanks. I have plenty of inner resources. Tonight, I barely had time to get ready. Catherine met me at the station and took me to some outdoor place. I know that you don't like her. But no matter what, Catherine's been my friend. Thank you for insisting that I call her. My navy blazer, my Turkish scarf. Yeah. It's so drafty on the stage, I left it on. And you, you're home now? Or have you been at home all night? For the board? Oh, right. Hello, are you still there? If this cuts out, my computer's on a wired connection. What's that? No, I'm still here. the key. I have it on my keyring. You can come and get it when you like. Or if not, that's all right. Stop saying sorry. It's not your fault. It's probably best. It was me who wasn't thinking. That's nice of you. Thanks for saying that. I am too. I didn't think I had it in me. Putting on an act. Hello? What? You think I'm putting on an act? As if I could. You know that I've never been able to pretend. Not at all. Not at all. I am calm. You would hear it. I said you would hear it. I don't have a voice that is capable of hiding what I'm feeling. No, I made my mind up not to look back, and so I won't. I got what I deserved. From the very beginning, I've been getting my own way. Baby, just listen. Hello, baby, please. Hello. Please just let me speak. This is not your fault. I made this happen. Yes. Yes. That weekend at the coast, in that awful cabin. There, you see, it was me who made us book the place. It was me who wasn't listening. It was me who was sure that this was what we needed. No, no, you're not being fair. I called you that very first time from a cab. Yes, I'm sure, January 4th. I think you know, I know all these dates by heart. Your mother, but why? It's not really worth the trouble. I don't have any plans. Yeah, I might be. Oh, no, no plans to travel right now. And you? Tomorrow. I had no idea it would happen so quickly. Okay, that's fine. That's no problem. Tomorrow morning, the key, I'll leave it by the front door. You could even ask Michael to pick it up there. It's possible even I could rent a place in the country with Catherine. That could be nice. I didn't hear what you said. I have been talking quite loud. Right now, can you hear me? I said, right now, can you hear me? That's funny. I can hear you just exactly as if we were in the same room. Hello? Hello? Okay, great. Now I can't. You're doing that robot voice. Yeah, but not well. It's faint. Are you at home? Sounds a little strange. No, that's good. That's the best it's sounded since you called. But there's some other noise in the background. It almost sounded like you're outside. You know, I can see you. I can tell you're in your coat still. You have your legs crossed at the ankle, but your thumbs are drumming away, making rhythms against your thigh. With your eyes closed, holding the phone with your shoulder up to your ear. Ah, you smiled. I have eyes where other people have ears. Oh God, let's not do that. I'm not in any state to be seen. Afraid. It's not that I'm afraid, just ragged. I'm not in the habit anymore of sleeping alone. Yeah. Yes. Sure. I'll do my best. I'll do my best. Stop being nice. I don't know. I can't bear to look in the mirror. I use the bathroom by the stage and won't even turn on the light. Last night, I came face to face with myself and thought some old man had broken in. No, I'm not some unshaven man with bags under his eyes. Really, I did not recognize myself. That's nice of you, but you should know. Calling me striking is worse than anything at all. Sounds like modern art. I preferred it when you said I had a face just begging someone to get it dirty. Lucky for me, you're such an awkward guy, and that you love me. If you were clever, and we didn't love each other, talking like this could be used as a terrible weapon. You could mutilate a person through the phone, without the dirty word. Being cruel. Hello? You think I'm being cruel? Are you there? Hello? Hi, can you still hear me? Hello? I lost you there. Hello? I'm sorry for calling so late. Is this Jen? Are you at home? Would you mind quickly running a message to next door? Not home. Oh, right. And he's not been home all night. Of course, he's at his parents'. With everything going on, I just forgot. You know how it is when you're not at home, you can lose track. I'm sorry to disturb you. I will. You too. Good night, Jen. Hello? Yeah, I can see you. Hello? You're in your car. No, I'll leave mine off. It's all right. Down here, it's a miracle just to get a signal. You know that? I know. You look worn out. It was good of you to call me back. Thanks for that. No. I'm still here. What? It's nothing. Never mind. No, no, nothing's wrong. Absolutely nothing wrong. It's the same. That is not what I mean. I don't know, we just talk and talk and talk. You know, in all this time, I have never lied to you. Yes, I know, it's not about that. I said I believe you, this is something else. I told a lie just now over the phone. No, when you first called, I told you an absolute lie. I'm aware that there is nothing left to hope for with us. But to lie is never going to change that. And I just don't like lying to you. I just can't stand to keep you in the dark, even for your own good. No, nothing serious like that. I just said I had on that scarf I got in Turkey and that I went out for a drink tonight with Catherine. I haven't been out. I don't have my Turkish scarf on. I've worn the same clothes for days, waiting to see if you would call. I put the cot where you get the best reception, and I've been here doing nothing, walking around, staring up into the dark, making myself crazy. At one point, I put on my coat, thinking I'd go out, get in a cab, and have it drive me past the house just to see. I know, see what? I don't know what I wanted to see. You're probably right. Sure. If you want me to. No, I'm plugged in now. If there's a problem, I'll turn it back off. Just here, ordered something in, but I couldn't eat. I've been sick to my stomach. Late last night, I wanted to take something to help me sleep. And then I thought if I took more than one, I'd sleep even better, and if I took them all at once, maybe I'd sleep without waking up, and this would be over. I softened up a handful in hot water, drank the sludge, and then I was dreaming of how things are with us. So when I woke back up, I felt happy, thinking it was just a dream. But when I realized where I was, that I was alone, sure that my body would stop breathing. Lightheaded, and cold. And I couldn't feel my own heartbeat. It was taking too long for me to die. But I felt choked by this terrifying blackness. Finally, after an hour, I called Catherine. I wasn't brave enough to die here on my own. My love. It was 4 o'clock in the morning.
Catherine had her husband call 911 while she kept me on the phone. Then a doctor called me. Catherine said that she'd normally come, but her husband's been sick, so they're being careful. They wanted an ambulance, though, but I convinced her to just keep me talking instead. I hate the hospital, and you had said you'd call. I'm okay. Better since you called. Hello? You're frozen. I'm turning video off. I appreciate that. You're being much nicer than I've been to you. Yes, please talk. Doesn't matter what you say. Even after the worst night of my life, hearing the sound of your voice is enough to make me feel okay. I can let my eyes close. You know, there were times when we your collarbone in that little place. When I heard your voice, it sounded exactly like it sounds now on the phone.
Hello? Is someone playing music? I said, is someone playing music? Okay, could you turn it back off? I'm already having a hard enough time hearing you through the phone as it is. It doesn't matter. I was finished. Someone from the clinic will check in on me tomorrow. There's no need to worry. Of course, you can write to Catherine for news. What? I said I feel fine. It's just that it's a good thing you called, or I'd be dead. I know how I sound. I know I'm being selfish and hysterical. And you have been as patient as you can be. I know. But it hurts. It hurts. It hurts. This call is the last signal we'll ever pass between us. The night before, I slept hard. I plugged in the phone and kept it on the pillow. No, no, just a cough. Yes, I know it's pathetic, but somehow with the phone beside me on the bed, I'm not alone. No matter what, we are still connected.
just as long as we're talking. The last 5 years, you have been my life. I have eaten and breathed just for you. Always waiting for you to come home, thinking you were dead if you weren't home on time. I would die thinking you were dead and come back to life when you walked in. Then when you were finally there, I'd die at the thought you might leave. But right now, I can breathe just as long as we're talking. So yeah, the night before last, I could sleep. I could sleep how you always sleep the first night away. When you are so worn out, what I don't know how to do is sleep the night after that, last night, and after that, tonight, and then day after day, going on and on. 'Cause you know, even if you manage to sleep, you still have the minefield of dreams to cross. Then you wake up, get cleaned up, get yourself dressed, and go out, but go out where? The unfortunate truth, nothing much has mattered in my life except you. Catherine and her husband have their own life. It's just me. Hello? I heard a voice. Is someone here? Oh, it's coming from my other phone. Hello? Hang on a sec. I've been on hold about the Wi-Fi here all day. Please, could you just send someone over? I'm on the other line at... What? How long have you been on? What? You have no idea? I will. No. No. He hung up on me. But not before he called us something I won't repeat. That got you upset? Yes, you're upset. I know your voice. You know it's not worth the trouble of getting worked up. He's probably deeply repressed. He's got no idea what we have between. You know that's not fair. We're a story to ourselves. Other people see in limited colors, breaking up or staying together. But it's not so simple. You could never make them understand that. You could never make them understand our situation. It's best just to treat it like a game. Let them say their piece and let it go. No. I just thought we were talking like we always used to. Then all of a sudden, I remembered where I was. Up till now, when things got bad, I knew that no matter what we said, no matter how awful, you might reach out and touch my face, I might squeeze your arm, remind ourselves of love. I could never manage that again. Now that I found out it involves throwing up, you know I'm deathly afraid of throwing up. How could I whip up the energy to make up a lie right now, my poor love? I couldn't. I could never muster the courage. But there are circumstances in which a lie is the best thing. If you had lied to me in order to spare me from learning something painful, I didn't say that you had lied. I said, if you had lied. And I found out, if, for example, you hadn't called from home tonight, but we're staying somewhere different. No, no, would you please just listen? I believe you. Yes, I know. There's no need to get so angry. I was trying to say that if you ever lied to spare my feelings, and I found out that you had, I wouldn't feel anything but tenderness for you. Hello? Hello? Oh God, make him call me back. 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 Oh God, make... We must have been cut off. I was just saying that if out of kindness you had hidden some truth, and I happened to find out about it, I'd only love you all the more for your concern. Of course! Sometimes it can feel like we're in the same room. Then all at once, the city rises up between us. Buildings and sidewalks and streets. I've pressed the phone so hard to my chest. I can feel your voice on my heart. Your voice inside of my ribs.
Even if they burned the towers down, you'd still be there.
Don't you think I know you too well to believe you could be so unkind? I can see you're trying to be tough, but I know this whole ordeal is just as brutal for you as for me. To Montreal. Hey, look, could I ask, since I know you'll be in Montreal the day after next, could I ask, at least I'd prefer, I'd prefer it if you wouldn't stay in that same hotel where we always stayed together. Would that be all right? It's just that if I can't picture a thing in my mind, it isn't real. It might exist in some less tangible place. That doesn't hurt as much. You know what I mean? Thank you. Thank you. You are good. I love
better.
Much better.